Welcome to Step by Step, a video Bible study series presented by the Monte Vista Church of Christ in Phoenix, Arizona.
Who is Lucifer? That is a common question that is asked by both religious and non-religious folks. And when answering this question, for many people, they will say that Lucifer is the devil. Lucifer is Satan. Lucifer is the evil one who constantly tempts the people of God. That is what most religious folks believe about Lucifer. But the question is that what the Bible says? Does the Bible say that Lucifer is the devil or Satan? It is interesting that the term or the name Lucifer is actually found in the Bible. In fact, it is found in one translation of the Bible, and that is the Old King James translation. In the Old King James translation, if you go to the book of Isaiah in the 14th chapter and in verse number 12, it says, "How art thou fallen from heaven, O Lucifer, son of the morning? How art thou cut down to the ground, which didst weaken the nations?" Here in Isaiah 14 and verse 12, the Bible mentions Lucifer. And many, when they go to this verse, they say that Lucifer, the Lucifer is, that is mentioned here, is the devil. It is talking about how the devil was kicked out of heaven. He was cut off and taken out of heaven because he was so evil. That is what many believe, but I want to suggest to you in this video that is not what this verse is teaching. Here in this verse, the Bible is not saying that Lucifer is the devil. Instead, it is talking about someone else. It is telling us that someone else is actually Lucifer. And so what can we learn from this? Well, there are three lessons that I want to share with you from Lucifer that is mentioned here in this text. First, from this text, I think we learn an important lesson about context. Context. You see, one of the most important rules of Bible study is keeping verses in their context. And so what is the context of Isaiah chapter 14 in verse number 12? Well, here in the context of Isaiah chapter 14 and verse 12, we need to understand that God is talking about the children of Israel. He is talking about how he was going to punish the enemies of Israel, those enemies who came against his people in the Old Testament, and how Israel was going to celebrate that. I think that's pretty clear when we look at the first few verses of this chapter in Isaiah chapter 14 and in verse number 3. In Isaiah 14 and verse 3, it says, "And it will be in the day when the Lord gives you rest from your pain and turmoil and harsh service in which you have been enslaved, that you will take up this taunt against the king of Babylon," notice, "the king of Babylon, and say how the oppressor has ceased and how fury has ceased." Notice how the context of this chapter is Babylon. It is talking about that nation that took Israel into 70 years of captivity. Here God is saying that he was going to punish Babylon. Specifically, he was going to punish the king of Babylon. The king of Babylon, probably Nebuchadnezzar, was going to be humbled because he came against God's people. And so the Lucifer that is mentioned here in this chapter is not a reference to the devil. It is a reference to the king of Babylon. He was going to be punished by God. He was going to be humbled by God. And so there's a lesson here about context. We need to keep verses in their context when we study the whole chapter and consider the context of Isaiah 14 and verse 12. We see very clearly that Lucifer is not the devil. Instead, it is the king of Babylon. And so that's one lesson we see here. But what's another lesson? Well, a second lesson we learn here is a lesson about the need to study the Bible for ourselves. You see, for a lot of people, they unfortunately believe that Lucifer is the devil because they're just parroting what they hear other folks say. They never bothered to open up the Bible and read the verse and study the chapter for themselves. Instead, they just go by what they've heard their parents tell them, or a preacher tell them, or a friend tell them. They need to learn to read the Bible for themselves. It reminds me of those who were in Berea that the Apostle Paul preached to in Acts 17 and verse 11. In Acts 17 and verse 11, the Bible says that those in Berea were more noble-minded than those in Thessalonica, for they received the word with great eagerness, examining the scriptures daily to see whether these things were so. Those in Berea that the Apostle Paul preached to were the kind of people who were willing to open up the Bible and examine the Bible for themselves. They didn't just take the Apostle Paul's word for it. They themselves opened up the Bible and they examined the things Paul taught with the rest of the things that were taught in the scriptures. And so that's what we need to do as well. We never need to take just someone's word for it, but we need to open up the Bible and see what the Bible says about these things. We need to open up the Bible and see what the Bible says about salvation. We need to open up the Bible and see, did Eve and Adam really eat an apple, or was it some unnamed fruit? We need to open up the Bible and see, are Christians obligated to keep the Old Testament law, or has that been done away with, or are we obligated to keep the new law of Jesus? You see, these are the kinds of issues that people just believe what a preacher tells them. But we need to open up the Bible and study it for ourselves. That's a lesson we learned from Lucifer. But then a third and final lesson is this. Just because people believe something is true, that doesn't automatically make it true. You see, the majority of folks in the religious world believe that Lucifer is the devil. And yet when we study our Bibles, we see that even though a majority of religious folks believe that, that doesn't automatically make it true. What makes something true is what God has declared about it, what the Lord has declared about it. In John 17 and verse 17, Jesus says that the Word of God is truth. In John 8 and verse 32, Jesus says that only the truth will set us free from our sins. And so, while the majority of people can be right about an issue, just because they're the majority doesn't automatically make them right. What makes something right is what God has declared about it. And when it comes to Lucifer, God has not declared Lucifer is the devil. Instead, God has declared that Lucifer is the king of Babylon in the context of Isaiah. And so there are many lessons that we can learn from Lucifer. But the key is this. Let's always just stick with the scripture. Let's always keep verses in their context, study for ourselves, and always make sure that we believe something, not just because people say it's true, but because God says it's true. If we follow these principles, it will help us not only study verses like Isaiah 14 and verse 12 and get a right understanding of them, but it will also help us get a right understanding of all God has said in His holy word.
Thanks for watching. For more online Bible study material, or to find more episodes in this series, visit us on our website at montevista.church.